6.
What's up, y'all? We're back. I am your host, Sporadic Erratic, and Ulvind is ready here for you to run the big journey any percent on Switch.
Hello. Hello, everyone. My name is Ulvind. Welcome to the big journey. So, for those wondering what this game is, you play this little cute cat called Mr. Whiskers. We're going to discuss...
Oh my god, Mr.
Yeah,
Whiskers.
Yeah, it's called Mr. Whiskers. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to reset settings. There we go. Because we have to start from a fresh file. So we will have to play. We have 25 levels in total, so that will be split in 5 zones. As you can see, these are locked right now. We will unlock them as we go by. And we will start, well, pretty much whenever we can. So let's start in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Keep in mind, if you suffer from motion sickness, some of the levels are going to be a little bit hard. Mostly because it's a game, I don't know if you recall a game called Loco Roco, where you basically move the stage instead of moving the character. This is basically the same premise in terms of the... in terms of the controls, at least. So here we have our little tutorial, where we will be introduced to absolutely everything. There we go. We...
Loco Roco, but kitty.
Yes.
So cute. I'm sorry. Yeah, it's
adorable. Yeah, especially when you hear it. You can hear his purrs as well in the game. So definitely pretty good. And here are. There we go. Mr. Rabbit, one of the friends we see along the way. There's a category as well that lets us see all the friends. But we will not do this. We will just go to rescue Mr. Chu as fast as we possibly can.
Wait. The cat.
Yeah, it's... So some things are...
The wait screen is the cat on the can. I mean, at least Mr. Whiskers has a newspaper.
Yeah. And here we are. We have these little conveyor belts that we will run over. There we go. Okay, I'm going to be a little bit cautious there because... you can soft lock on these moving platforms. So I need to be a little bit cautious so I don't soft lock on this. It happened to me more than once during runs, and it actually loses quite a bit of time, so I need to be very. There we go. There we go. There we go. Here are these bouncy platforms, and there we go. Sushi cat. A cat that loves sushi. And we are done with level 2. So as I said, we have a total of 25 levels. That will be split in 5 zones. There we go. So. Third level here.
Would this be an okay time for donation?
Sure, sure, go ahead.
Alright, well, Woodside sent in $30, and this is what they had to say, less than 3. Thank you so much for your generosity, Woodside, and I noticed that you put that towards the incentive that we are trying to unlock by the end of this run. The incentive that we're trying to unlock is for the very next run. That is the Toho 6 Embodiment of the Scarlet Devil extra category, and if we meet it, George will also run the extra category in Toho 6 Embodiment of the Scarlet Devil. We were looking for $100 to unlock that. We now have $30 towards it, so only only $70 left. We just need to raise $70 for Save the Music before the end of this run. So please do get those donations in if you are able to do so.
So yeah, shout-outs to Woodside and shout-outs to the Baguette Academy crew. So normally they were supposed to restream the this event in French. Sadly, there was not enough people available, so they had to cancel the restream. But yeah, shout-outs to the French, the Baguette restream crew. Don't worry, I have my baguette near me. I will show it at the end of the run. Oh,
there we go. Just bonus baguette.
Yeah.
This run just keeps getting better and better. Cute cats, sushi, baguettes. Bees.
There we go. Bees. Right, level 4. Rainy slide. So we have this stage in the rain, which means everything is slippery. So it helps us go a little bit faster. Basically sliding. And those heavy winds that you see here that can take us from one end of the level to another. So, I didn't really talk about the premise of the game. So basically, you are Mr. Whiskers, and your objective is that the owner of the dumplings joint that you frequent, Mr. Chu, has disappeared into the forest. So what are you going to do? You're going to go into the forest to save him, and you're going to have quite a lot of adventures in this forest. You're going to see quite a lot of friends, and yeah, that's basically the premise of the game.
That is also adorable. Also, I'd like to say that this is like you are what you eat in action, since this cat is basically a dumpling as well.
So. We usually call it potato cat. Right, and level 5, Carnival. This game has this game from time to time just decides to boot you into the wrong level. Like, into a level you have already done once, which is definitely inconvenient for a speedrun. It actually happened during one of my PBs as well. Because I entered the wrong stage twice by accident, and ended up losing about 35 seconds to a minute.
So I still PB'd,
yeah, because in my previous PB, I actually softlocked.
Oh.
There we go. Okay, cautious there. There we go. And we have this spot there where we just go down this flight of platforms. So keep in mind, there are no health points, etc. It's just, if you get hit, you get hit. It's fine.
Really? You can just get hit however many times?
Yeah. You can get hit however many times you want, and it won't have any impact. You will just lose a dumpling if you ate one. And if you haven't eaten dumplings, it basically doesn't do anything.
I mean, what a travesty. Taking dumplings from Mr. Whiskers.
Alright, so now we enter a pretty big forest during the night, and yeah. We're going to switch atmospheres for something a little bit more night mood. There we go. Oh, there we go. Please. Okay. So here we have this switch that we have to press. There we go. There we go. It's pretty far away, so we'll have the double cutscene. Okay, we won't have the double cutscene. Because one of the one of the bugs this game has is that it can actually give you a cutscene twice and make you lose about 4 or 5 seconds. But we didn't have the cutscene bug, so it's fine. Oh, there we go. Please. There we go. Okay, we didn't touch the fruit. Nice. Bad things happen if you touch the fruit. There we go.
I mean, to be fair, cats don't like fruit. Though.
Okay, good. Didn't touch the fruit. So it's actually faster to go down there rather than to go up there. And we are done with stage 2 1. Let's see. Oh yeah, because all the stages basically have, well, kind of a different color. So you can see here, you will have shades of like blue-green in this world at the very least. Then the next world we have shades in the yellow/red, and yeah, there's going to be quite a lot of shades of color. This game is actually very colorful. Nice. Skip the cutscene, because you can also skip these cutscenes. It saves you. Like 2-3 seconds? Not exactly massive, but still there. There we go. I'm going to be pretty cautious there, because it's definitely. There we go, yeah. Here's why. It's a very hard platforming section. There we go. There we go. So here we're going to stop a little bit. We'll wait until the platform. There we go. And there we go. Sometimes it's just better to not risk the jump and losing quite a bit of time in the process and just, you know, just going to wait. It's fine. There we go. So yeah, this is what I was talking about. Basically, when you get hit by an enemy or anything else, you basically lose a dumpling and that's it.
Is there some point to collecting a lot of them by the end of the game, or...?
Not really. It's just like 1, 2, 3 stars by the end, but it's only... Well, it only matters for the 100%, but for the any percent, it's just, yeah, just roll with it. Just go as fast as possible, and
I mean, just roll with it seems like you know, the theme of the game.
Yeah, it's kind of the theme of the game. Okay, oh, there we go. We have this platform there. As you can see, we have the switch that is hidden. Just have to activate. There we go. Nice. As we can see, we skip the cutscene again. Oh. It's going to be a little bit complicated there, but we will manage. There we go. That's better. It's So keep in mind, if you're interested in this game, it is available on Switch and PC. I'm playing it on Switch because, well, I found it on Switch first, and it's more convenient. Okay, let's see the next level.
Mr. Whiskers is a very durable cat.
Yeah.
It'd take a lot of punishment for dumplings. They're worth it.
Yeah, he's ready to do anything just for dumplings.
Okay, time to talk about our incentives?
Sure, go ahead.
Awesome. Well, just to remind everybody, we are trying to unlock the Toho 6 Embodiment of the Scarlet Devil extra category for the run immediately after this game, if it is met. George will also run the extra category in Toho 6 Embodiment of the Scarlet Devil. We're looking for $100 to unlock that, and we're sitting at $30, so we just need to raise $70 more by the end of this run. And just a note, if we do that, we will also have hit $4,000 raised for Save the Music. So please do get those donations in, and please remember to take a look at all of our incentives and bid wars that we have available.
I just noticed that I forgot to turn my alerts off in Twitch, so... Which is weird, because the alerts are in a separate scene, so I'm surprised it ran. Did ring.
I'm getting alerts in Discord, so it's all good. It's all good.
Oh, there we go. We have those big enemies right now, and here the conveyor belts are going backwards now, so you have to just jump as fast as you possibly can to make sure it goes... There we go, we're going to drop down, because we have to drop down for this. Sometimes the most optimal path is not exactly what you think it is, like for example here you have to jump down. And you were like, do I really jump down? And you continue, you jump over the obstacle, and you find that, yeah, you had to go down, actually. There we go. You can get carried by these conveyor belts. And voila, pretty short stages. And we are out the forest and going into the deep, deep desert. Here is where trouble begins. There are a lot of places where you can actually softlock here, so I need to be a little bit more cautious than usual, especially here. There we go. Those, don't exactly know what it is. Things shaped like fidget spinners, pretty much. Jump over these enemies, but sometimes it's just better to just try to land on the right side of an enemy so you can get some damage boost. Like, given you have no penalty for actually hitting an enemy, sometimes just do this. Sometimes it's even beneficial to just land on the right side of an enemy. Go. Oh, And there we go, we had the two cutscenes. So what happened is we basically had two cutscenes playing one after the other. Loses a bit of time. Not that much, to be fair, so... we're good. God, okay, we need to be cautious with this one. I have softlocked more than once on this stage. So basically, if you go on the right of a... on the left of this platform, that is, against the wall, you can get hung into the wall and basically get softlocked inside. I hope it doesn't happen. But it's definitely pretty... definitely pretty funny when it happens. Because you look at your character being completely stretched inside a wall. There we go. We are taking this high winds. There we go.
You really thought Mr. Whiskers could survive anything, but... being stuck in the wall, not so much.
I mean, he can survive being stuck in the wall, it's just that he'll be stuck forever.
And then he doesn't get any dumplings, so, you know.
Yeah.
We can't have that.
That's the worst thing that can ever happen.
Not getting any dumplings. I seriously want dumplings. Okay, what is this game doing to me?
The hottest place. There we go. And here you can see we landed on the left side, so we got pushed back.
How do you feel about a donation right now?
Sure, go ahead.
Alright, well, Woodside sent in another $30 and said less than three. Thank you so much, Woodside, for your generosity. And that, in fact, did go towards that incentive that we are trying to unlock by the end of this run, the Toho 6 embodiment of the Scarlet Devil extra category. We're now sitting at $60 out of the $100. We need to unlock that. Let's take a look at the time. Looks like we have about 20 minutes or so, 20, 25 minutes based on your estimate. Would you say about 20 minutes?
About 20 to 22, I'd say.
So we have a little over 20 minutes, possibly. We're looking to raise $40 if everybody in the chat we don't even need everybody in chat. We only need 40 people in chat to donate $1. That is less than a third of you. So please do get those donations in for Save the Music. Click on that Toho 6 embodiment of the Scarlet Devil extra category and let's unlock that extra category.
I would love to actually do a donation. Sadly, I'm playing right now.
Well, you know, there might be a little bit of time, you know, before, I'm not sure if we need to make it exactly at the beginning of the run or when it needs to be met. In fact, if staff could confirm when exactly we need to have met, if it's partway through the Toho 6 run or if it is at the beginning. Yeah, just somebody ping me and let me know and I will give everybody the updated info up to the minute how late you can donate to unlock that incentive.
To wait a little bit because I tend to go a little fast and get stuck inside this wall right here. That goes down, up and down. There we go. Here we go over these branches. Okay, we jumped over the fruit. Nice. Okay, so next we're going 3-5, if I recall correctly. Yep. Stage 15. World 3, stage 5. Wild Night. Yep. We have this block that we have to break. We have to break it twice. It's definitely going to be a pain sometimes because it's very, very difficult to control your character exactly. Oh, very nice damage boost there. Suddenly can land on this side. Had to get taken by the... taken by the heavy wind, so we can drop... we have to drop right here, to be precise. There we go. One, two, there we go.
Alright, so I did just hear from staff that we have until the end of the Toho run, so it's not, it would be, instead of 15 minutes from now, people have, like 40 minutes from now, because it's the Toho run, which is 25 minutes, so we have about 40 minutes to raise $40.
Nice. Yeah, it's definitely doable.
Feels like it, right?
Yeah. So, right now, we have entered the caves. So pretty dark caves here. We're going to be to get closer to... oh, there we go. I've got this switch right here. Oh! Okay. Need to focus a little bit, please. Okay, my switch just... okay. I need to stop for a second. Just... oh my god, it's happening again. Please. So what happened is, if you don't know what happened, then just see absolutely nothing. So my switch, there we go, just decided to completely disconnect. Should be good. We're good. Where am I? Okay, I'm here.
Nice save. The controller just disconnected?
No, it's just the switch that completely disconnected.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah, because I'm playing on a setup with normally my Ethernet cable, because my Wi-Fi is dead on my switch. And what happens is sometimes the it just decided to randomly disconnect. It happened just before the run. I was hoping it didn't happen during the run, but sadly it did.
Well, excellent recovery.
I mean, it's mostly because I'm used to it. Like, not exactly ruining my runs, but it happened that it disconnected more than once during one of my Mario Kart matches, mostly. So here we're just rolling through these stages there. There we go. Pretty short stage, less than a minute. There's going to be a few more stages like this that are going to be close to or less than a minute. Okay, closer to the lava, because yes, we are going inside a volcano. Because yes, as I said, Mr. Whiskers will live lots of adventures.
There's nowhere Mr. Whiskers won't go for dumplings.
Oh, there we go.
Okay. Alright, how do you feel about a donation right now?
Sure, sure, go ahead, go ahead.
Well, believe it or not, I sent in $20 with the comments. Only $20 to go, which in fact brings us to only $20 to go before the end of the next run. We only need $20 more for Save the Music. Please get those donations in so we can unlock that Toho Embodiment of the Scarlet Devil extra category. We only need $20 more, and if we get those $20, we will also have raised $4,000 for nice. Save the Music. We're so close.
Collate. Yeah, Toho is a treat to watch. So I'm definitely looking forward to it. Nice. Now we can drop down, get into this pretty sinuous track right there. We're hoping to get upwards. Come on! There we go. Just get carried by the wind here. Just chilling, you know.
Just chilling in the volcano.
Just chilling in the volcano, yeah. That's what you do, right? You just chill. And there we go.
Cool thoughts.
Go right in the center, and that's the end of the stage. End of World 4, Rays of Light, we have exited the volcano now, and we are slowly but surely making our way towards the end. Here we have this switch that we have to activate. Sadly, it is on the other side, so we have to get... Oh! Did it just... What? It got displaced a few pixels for some reason. Okay, interesting. I never saw that.
You say that's the... That's never happened before?
This has probably happened before to someone else, but it has never happened to me at the very least.
Alright.
There we go. Okay, so here we're going to get this switch right there. There we go. Looking at a very nice number on my screen right now. 4,000.
I know, right? It's very exciting. Well, Sunjo sent in $16 with no comment, just generosity, and with that we have raised $4,000.
Let's go.
For Save the Music. Let's go. Thank you so, so much. Thank you so much.
Yeah, we're going to drop there. There we go. Yeah, this is a place where we can self-lock very easily, so I need to be pretty cautious. And here, I'm going to go on the other side, because we have to activate this switch right there, and then drop down. Oh, and missed it. There we go. It's just the backup, don't worry. we'll continue on our merry way.
I do want to remind everybody that we are still trying to unlock that incentive, though. We are so, so close. We are still sitting at $80 out of the $100 that we need to unlock the Toho 6 Embodiment of the Scarlet Devil extra category, which if we meet it, the George will run the extra category in Toho 6 Embodiment of the Scarlet Devil, which is the very next run. So we're looking to unlock that by the end of that run.
And it's coming actually sooner than you might think. We have 4 stages left, to be precise. And let's see how this stage will actually go. Volcano lands. One of the stages... I practiced a few stages before this run, and this was one of them. The previous one was definitely one of them, because you can softlock very easily, and at least I didn't softlock there.
You know, I do want to point out also that when we raise that final $20 to unlock that incentive, our total will be 4,020, which is pretty nice.
Hey, let's go. There we go. Didn't want to take any risks. Took it safe, and there we are. Oh, no. Yep, there we go. I didn't notice the fruit. Yep, this is what happens when you eat the fruit, guys. Don't do it.
Oh, wow. Well, I have one more donation that has come in. Is it all right if I read that right now?
Yeah, sure, go ahead.
All right, well, Woodaside sent in another $20 with the comment, less than three, less than three. Less than three. My gosh, Woodaside. Thank you so much for your incredible generosity with that. We have actually met that incentive for the Toho 6 Embodiment of the Scarlet Devil extra category, and George will be running the extra category in the very next game. Thank you very, very much. Incentive hype!
Let's go.
And yes, now our total raised for Save the Music Foundation is 4,020.
Nice. Okay, we have the second fruit that we didn't touch this time. Good. Oh, there we go. We have this bar here. Drop down. Get the switch. And there we go. Yes. And we are only like less than two. We are now 2 levels away from the end. So will we get a sub 40? I don't think so. It's going to be really close, but it's not going to be a sub 40, sadly. Especially if I do this. Come on. There we go. Because the black sheep threw us in the wrong direction, so of course we had to adjust. There we go, yeah, that's... this section is really hard. It's almost at the end as well, so you have to be pretty cautious. There we go, and this part... There we go, we got it. Please, come on. There we go. One, let's do. Just go over. Oh, by the way, this one, this switch opens a path that we won't go towards. Because it pretty much leads to only a dumpling, if I recall correctly. Alright, and we are entering the very last level of the game. So it's already autumn. For those wondering, this is the last level of the game. One of the longest as well, about 2 minutes long. So if nothing bad happens, which I hope, if nothing bad happens, we should be done in about 2 minutes.
So Mr. Whiskers has been trying to save the dumpling chef.
Mm-hmm.
Through multiple seasons at this point.
Oh, there we go. Jumping in.
And multiple biomes as well.
So I can drop down here. There we go. Okay. There we go. Nice. We didn't get soft locked. Because as you can see, basically stuck on these platforms there. Okay, drop down. There we go. Nope. Yeah, I was expecting this. That's fine. I was expecting this as well. There we go. Very cautious, because these three platforms as well, you can softlock on them. I wouldn't want to softlock on the last stage. And there we go, yeah. And the last softlock spot has pretty much been... we pretty much went for it. So normally we should be fine until the end of the level. Nope. Come on. Thank you. Alright, so tech, get ready, because it's going to be time as soon as the screen fades to black. And get ready, time.
GG.
Yes, about 41:30, which is a pretty good time. About a minute away from my PB, though. And yeah, so here's what happens. We find Mr. Chu, and yeah, just sees us. Like, Mr. Whiskers was confused. Mr. Chu seems to be fine. Wasn't kidnapped. Wasn't stuck in a well. What happened? He was just sleeping, you know? Was just dozing off, like nothing happened. So only someone was brave enough, determined enough, hungry enough to find me, and that's you. Just kidding, I know you've come a long way, so take some time to rest. And now, yeah. That's the end. So, massive thank you for Midwest Speedfest for actually inviting me for this event. As you can see, I'm living pretty far away from the event, and yeah, it's actually a pretty nice occasion to be able to run during these events. Massive shout outs to the French, to the Baguette Academy, who were planning to do the restream for the event, but sadly couldn't because of a lack of people. And as a celebration, I will just eat my baguette. And yeah, it was a pleasure. Thank you all, and see you next time. And see you for the next run, which is going to be Toho 6. Let's go.
Right, in case people didn't hear it. And then the actual eating of the baguette, of course. We can't cut yet. We definitely have to see the eating of the baguette. Thank you so much, Ulvind, for that adorable run of the big journey. And as Ulvind said, coming up next, it is Toho 6 Embodiment of the Scarlet Devil. Hard, no bombs, don't go anywhere.